In this video, we will try to save a Spea ISA video card from eBay with kitchen paper, and I will show you how you can game with over 100 Hz on a CRT under real DOS. Alright, to test the card, we will use this vintage 386 SX16 here, which is totally in original condition. This is the card, ain't it beautiful? Alright, we have two options here, we can connect it to a TFT or a CRT. But since we want to go with high hertz, we have to connect it to a CRT because the TFT could not drive the card in this way. Okay, time to test it and see if it works. It was sold as untested, I should add. Alright. This doesn't look good. It was green for a second. Nope. This doesn't work at all. Alright, there's one trick that I know that we can use. Sometimes you have layering on these connectors here, and you can scrub it away with such a simple thing as kitchen paper. Okay, let's test again, see what happens this time. Oh, we have green again. This time it stays. Ah, there you go, picture. So we saved this card from the trash, which is amazing, since this card is really good. Okay, now let me show you why this card is good and really special. As you see, we currently have 70 Hz on this CRT monitor, which is standard DOS. Every video card can do this. But watch what happens when we install the correct driver for this card and set the card up correctly. To be fair, I should add that there are surely more cards that can do this. But the problem is always to find the correct drivers for them today. Let's boot it again. We are still at 70 Hz, but watch what happens when we activate the high Hz tool from the driver. We have to load it again now. And there you go. Now you see that our shutter speed is no longer correct on the camera because we have 90 Hz. But this is not all. This is just what the card does under DOS environment. When you start a game, you will automatically have 100 Hz under real DOS with those Spea cards. And this is really special. And this works with every Spea Mirage video card, no matter if it's ISA, VESA Local Bus or PCI. And that's the main reason why I only use these cards in my Retro PCs.